Great Spirit, whose voice we hear on the wind, whose breath gives life to the universe, I come to you as one of your children. I am small, simple, and weak. I need your strength, wisdom, and guidance. I thank you for this day of life. I thank you for the rain that is coming down today, for the life-giving force that you are giving to the world in the storm. I ask you to watch over us and guide us as we journey on this path of life. I ask you to forgive me for my shortcomings and help me walk in a better way. And I ask you to do so with love and mercy, and not to give me more than I can bear. I have made many mistakes in life, and I make them every day. I am far from imperfect. I am just a simple man, and often not a very good one. But I also know and understand that you have created me this way, and that is not a cop-out. But I know there is a reason for it, that you have created me this way to learn and grow from the experiences I have in life, especially the adverse ones. And I know the ego side of me often screws that up, because when I don't walk humbly, I speak and act out of anger and emotion, and my mouth gets me in a lot of trouble and hurts people. For that, I truly am sorry. And I realize that this is not a good thing for my children. I need to process things in a different way. And I need to always remind myself and remember every day that it is those little ones that it is most important. They are the center of my world, and everything that I do and say, I must consider their well-being. And in my selfishness, I have given in to my resentment, bitterness, and anger. And at times, have not recognized what is most important. And I ask the Spirit to forgive me. And I thank the Spirit for teaching me and helping me through it. I must let go of my resentment. I cannot selfishly hold on to pain and resentment. It will only breed more hurt. My ego doesn't want to be the doormat anymore and doesn't want to be hurt. And I understand that is an instinctual, defensive part of who I am. Star and Dan, I do not wish you any harm. A part of me is very hurt and angry, and I'm processing that, and it's hard. Some things I can process quickly, other things takes me a while. And I have to constantly be vigilant to not allow my mouth to get me in trouble or hurt people. because I am a barker, not a biter. I try to bark as a way of release. Release some of that pressure so that I don't bite. And that may not be a good way of doing it, and I'm learning how to do it better. And I got a long ways to go. Part of me wants to send you and your new partner nothing but love and white light. And that other part of me, that injured, angry part of me, wants you to both feel and experience the same pain or similar pain. But I know that's not necessarily right, and it's not going to help anybody. So I relinquish this shadow of resentment I carry to the spirit of karma. I give it to you, and I ask you to take this burden from me and guide us all to the path that the Creator wants us to follow. And please do so in the most loving and merciful way that you can. Grant us blessings, all of us. Blessings, whether they be financial or otherwise, but blessings that will be good for all of us and always help us to be vigilantly conscious that all of these blessings are ultimately for the well-being of the children and the generations to come. I don't normally record prayer and share it with the world, but this one I am. It's very personal, and it will touch somebody, maybe in a good way. And the selfish part of me tells me that it's helping me process, which is necessary for my healing, because I can't be any good to anybody else if I don't strive for that. And I'm not always going to do such a good job of it. I'm going to make my mistakes. And I'm going to screw up a lot. I've always been good at that. But I think I've grown and come a long way. And through the blessing that Spirit has given me in experience and wise people that come into my life and give me counsel, through all of those things, maybe I can get through this a little bit better than I have other things in the past. That is my hope. No one knows the future, but I hold on to the faith that the spirits are at work with the best interest of the whole at the center of intention. I gotta hold on to that faith. It's difficult to hold on to at times through these situations, but it's essential to my survival, to my personal healing, and to the well-being of my children, my friends, and my family. All of this is a very hard thing to swallow for me. And even though I may not be so good at processing it and handling it all. I'm trying. And I'm giving it the best I got with what I got to work with. Forgive me for my shortcomings, Great Spirit. Thank you for the beautiful adversities of life. And thank you for helping me learn to embrace those adversities in a way that can be helpful and not hurtful. And thank you for forgiving me for when I fail and writing me on the path that is before me. No, and I'm sick, Nogama, Willah, and Gizilo. Thank you. I'm sick, Nogama, all our relations. Willah. Thank you, Great Spirit. Oh, amen. Have a good day.